Oh, good morning, my friends. I was just reading the newspaper, reading up about some of our elected officials. Yes, there are some elections that'll be coming up soon, and I'd like to know about my elected officials and who's running. Have you ever participated in an election? That is picking someone who is to make decisions for you. They could be your class president, for an example. But as you get older, you choose bigger positions. City mayor, city council, school board, president of the United States. These are the people who make big decisions for you all the time. So how do you pick them? Well, there's a lot of great ways of looking at them. I tried to look at them by reading the newspaper and listening to the news and finding out what they've done. Now, a great example is about a young girl named Sofia Valdez. What? You've never heard of Sofia Valdez? Well, let me share her story with you, and it gives you some good clues of what you might want to look at when it comes time for you to vote for someone. Our story today is Sofia Valdez, future president. Sofia was a baby who got things done, helping her family before she turned even one. She started early. She and Abdullah went out every week to help elderly friends around Blue Ribbon Creek, who couldn't get out and about on their own, and with no place to gather, they were stuck home alone. We know how that feels right now, don't we, boys and girls? Raking the leaves, taking pets for a walk, or just dropping by for a treat and a talk. Sofia Valdez did as much as she could for her family and friends and her whole neighborhood. A dreamer, a doer, a real-life go-getter. Most people like good, but Sofia, well, she liked better. Each morning, Abdullah walked Sofia to class. They walked home again along Blue River Pass, making plans, munching cookies, Abdullah and girl, except that Tuesday when Pup saw the squirrel. With a howl, Pup took off, racing through the town, over, under, beneath, and around. Sofia scrambled to try to keep up with the hollering and the bellowing pup. Oh dear, what's this? Up the squirrel ran to the top of the hill made of leftover junk for the local landfill. They reached the tippy top to that mountain of trash which jiggled and broke with an ear-splitting crash. Down they all tumbled and hit with a thud. Only a moldy old pumpkin surrounded by mud. Ouch, cried Abdullah. He struggled to stand. A dangerous mess, he said, grasping her hand. The next day, Sofia walked to school solo, but it wasn't the same without her Abdullah. This is not right, declared young Sofia, who glared at the Mount Trashmore and got an idea. I wonder what idea she has come up with, looking at a pile of trash that she's named Mount Trashmore. The very next morning, at 12:30, she planted a sign at the front of the lawn. She stood back and smiled, and Pup gave a bark. Arf, arf. What does it say, boys and girls? Get rid of Mount Trashmore. Let's build a new park. Wow, what a wonderful idea. Each of her neighbors had something to say about benches and fountains and places to play. Meeting spots, gardens, a basket for bees, a rubber duck pond, and a kiosk for cheese. She drew every thought on her map of the park, which was perfectly perfect by a quarter till dark. She drifted to sleep in her soft, cozy bed. Then, bam! She woke up with a thought smacked in her head. Her heart skipped a beat as she realized each one of her neighbors had said, "Let me know when it is done." They all thought Sofia could build it alone. But how could one girl do so much on her own? The way of that thought made her tender heart ache as night thunder growled and she laid wide awake. Then the dawn brought a storm and the gloomy sky wept and the heartsick Sofia finally slept. Abdullah baked cookies when Sofia got up. She gave her bagful and sneaked one for Pup. He blinked back a tear as he hugged his Sofia. "For courage," he whispered, "I love you, my dear." Sophia's knees wobbled. She felt weak inside. She looked at his ankle and quite nearly cried. Though she didn't feel brave or courageous at all, Sofia Valdez went to face City Hall. This is where all of our city elected officials are. Oh, look, there's the library. And look how big City Hall is. And look how tiny Sofia is. This is scary, isn't it, boys and girls? To go in a big place like that all alone? She went to the mayor's office. The mayor's office sent her to room 401, the Blue River Creek Department of Fun, which sent her downstairs to room 302, the office of duck ponds and cool things to do. The office of monkeys, then the department of cheese, the division of fountains and meetings and bees, then down to the basement so musty and cramped where all the town's papers were sorted and stamped. And that's where the clerk said what no one else did.
"You can't build a new park. You're only a kid."
Boy, they have sent her everywhere. And now someone's saying that she can't do it because she's only a kid. Do you think this stops Sofia? Well, let's see. Well, those words smacked Sofia deep down in her heart. Her plan was kibosh before it could even start. "I think," said Sofia, "I think that law's wrong." But her second grade voice didn't sound very strong. The clerk said,
"Clearly, it cannot be done. Do you have any questions?"
Sofia said, "One.
If you were me, and I was you, and he was your grandpa, what would you do?"
Well, I said the clerk.
Then she said nothing at all. She thought, and she thought. Then she sent out a call to every employee throughout City Hall? What a good question. If I can't do it, what would you do? She didn't have an answer. The entire government of Blue River Creek crammed into the office to hear Sophie speak, but her words jumbled up and her cheeks turned bright red as a dozen emotions run into her head. Her heart beat so loudly she thought it would crack. The crowd leaned in closer. Sophia leaned back, and her arms brushed the edge of the old cookie sack. And that was the moment when Sophia first knew being brave means doing the thing you must do. Though her heart cracks with fear, though you're just in grade two, she took a deep breath, look the mayor in the eye, and though her knees wobbled, she held her head high. Sophia started talking. She spelled out her plan and why it all mattered and how it began. And once she got rolling, she had lots to say about meeting spots, monkeys, and places to play, and other ideas for things they could do to help the town elders and the other folks too. She had thoughts on the library, thoughts on the zoo, and perhaps a way to combine the two, and All right, cried the mayor. Go start a petition. If the town wants a new park, we'll form a commission. And so young Sophia got right to work with some help from her family and pup and the clerk. Oh, look at all everybody. The others joined in, not all, but a few, like Miss Lilla Greer and the kids in grade two. There were hearings and surveys and taxes to figure, then bulldozers, cranes, and blue bigger diggers. They all built that park. That's how it got done, with the hard work of, by, and for everyone. But it began with the dream of one person, just one, who laced up her shoes and then led the way to help Blue River Creek get a new place to play. Now every evening till long after dark, the town comes together at Citizens Park. They all hold this truth to be self-evident, that Sofia Valdez could grow up to be president. Until then, Sofia, that's a real-life go-getter, helps Blue River Creek get better and better. The end. Sofia Valdez, future president. I loved what she did. She went out, she made a plan, and she spoke up for it. But most importantly, did she do it all of herself? No. She started out doing some of the things by herself, but then she brought people together. That's what I look for and a leader. Someone who can bring us together. Someone who will have to make some big decisions. Sometimes not the popular decisions, but someone who is working for all of us to do great things. When Sophia gets old enough, I'm voting for her. She's demonstrated that she's a leader. How are you demonstrating today that you are a leader? What can you do? Well, boys and girls, you have a great day, and we will see you later. Bye.